Elisha and the Prophets of Baal. Prophet Elisha. When the people of Israel started to worship idols, the prophet Elisha delivered a message from God to King Ahab that there will be neither dew nor rain in the next few years until I say so. For the next 3 years, there was no rain, so harvest failed and there was famine everywhere. God told Elisha to hide in the Kerit ravine and had been fed by ravens. When the brook dried up, God then told him to travel north out of the country where he was fed by a widow living at Zarephath. After some time, in the third year of the drought, the Lord said to Elisha, "Go and present yourself to King Ahab, and I will send rain." So Elisha started out from Zarephath. Samaria. Elisha left Zarephath and traveled south into the land of Israel. The famine in Samaria was at its worst. Ahab, the king of Israel, called in Obadiah, who was in charge of the palace. Obadiah was a devout worshipper of the Lord. And when Queen Jezebel was killing the Lord's prophets, Obadiah took 100 of them, hid them in caves in 2 groups of 50, and provided them with food and water. King Ahab said to Obadiah, "Let us go and look at every spring and every river bed in the land to see if we can find enough grass to keep the horses and mules alive. Maybe we won't have to kill any of our animals." They agreed on which part of the land each one would explore and set off in different directions. As Obadiah was on his way, he suddenly met Elisha. He recognized him, bowed low before him and asked, "Is it really you, sir?" Then Elisha answered, "Yes, I am. Go and tell your master, the king Ahab, that I am here." Obadiah answered, "What have I done that you want to put me in danger of being killed by King Ahab? By the living Lord, your God, I swear that the king has made a search for you in every country in the world. And now you want me to go and tell him that you are here. What if the Spirit of the Lord carries you off to some unknown place as soon as I leave? Then when I tell King Ahab that you are here and he can't find you, he will put me to death." Then Elisha answered, "By the living Lord whom I serve, I promise that I will present myself to the king today." So Obadiah left and went to King Ahab and told him. And Ahab set off to meet Elisha. When Ahab saw him, he said, "So there you are, the worst troublemaker in Israel." Then Elisha answered, "I am not the troublemaker. You are, you and your father. You are disobeying the Lord's commands and worshipping the idols of Baal. Now order all the people of Israel to meet me at Mount Carmel. Bring along the 450 prophets of Baal and the 400 prophets of the goddess Asherah who are supported by the queen Jezebel." So Ahab summoned all the Israelites and the prophets of Baal to meet at Mount Carmel. The 450 prophets of Baal and the 400 prophets of false god Asherah were also summoned. Then Elisha went up to the people and said, "How much longer will it take you to make up your minds? If the Lord is God, worship him. But if Baal is God, worship him." But the people did not say a word. Elisha continued saying, "I am the only prophet of the Lord still left, but there are 450 prophets of Baal. So bring two bulls. Let the prophets of Baal take one, kill it, cut it in pieces, and put it on the wood. But don't light the fire. I will do the same with the other bull. Then let the prophets of Baal pray to their God, and I will pray to the Lord. And the one who answers by sending fire is, he is the Lord God." Then people shouted their approval. Then Elisha said to the prophets of Baal, "Since there are so many of you, you take a bull and prepare it first. Pray to your God, but don't set fire to the wood." Prophets of Baal took the bull that was brought to them, prepared it and prayed to Baal until noon. They shouted, "Answer us, Baal," and kept dancing around the altar they had built. But no answer came. Then Elisha at noon started making fun of them. "Pray louder. He is a god. Maybe he is daydreaming or relieving himself. Or perhaps he is gone on a journey. Or maybe he is sleeping. And so you have got to wake him up." So the prophets of Baal prayed louder and cut themselves with knives and daggers, according to their ritual, until blood flowed. They kept on ranting and raving until the middle of the afternoon, but no answer came, not a sound was heard. Then Elisha said to the people, "Come closer to me." And they all gathered round him. He set about repairing the altar of the Lord, which had been torn down. He took 12 stones, one for each of the 12 tribes, named after the sons of Jacob, the man to whom the Lord had given the name Israel. With these stones, he rebuilt the altar for the worship of the Lord. He dug a trench round it, large enough to hold almost 14 liters of water. Then he placed the wood on the altar, cut the bull in pieces, and laid it on the wood. He said, "Fill your jars with water and pour it on the offering and the wood." They did so. And he said, "Do it again." And they did. "Do it once more," he said. And they did. The water ran down the altar and filled the trench. At the hour of the afternoon sacrifice, the prophet Elisha approached the altar and prayed, "O Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, prove now that you are the God of Israel, and that I am your servant, and have done all this at your command." Elisha prayed, "Answer me, Lord, answer me, so that this people will know that you, the Lord our God, and that you are bringing them back to yourself." The Lord answered and sent fire down, and it burnt up the sacrifice, the wood, and the stones, scorched the earth, and dried up the water in the trench. When the people saw this, they threw themselves on the ground and exclaimed, "The Lord is God, the Lord alone is God." Then Elijah ordered, "Seize the prophets of Baal. Don't let any of them get away." The people seized them all, and Elijah led them down to the river Kishon and killed them.